A very good evening to one and all present here. On behalf of Dr. Suresh Kumar Murugesan, the team lead of this webinar series, and also on behalf of the core team members and the organizer, the Department of Psychology, the American College Madurai, and the associating partners, Madras School of Social Work Chennai, Red Pond Educational and Psychological Research Center Madurai, Yellow Pond Counseling Center Madurai, MS Chellamuthu Institute of Mental Health and Rehabilitation Madurai, and Psycho-Oncological Association Turkey, I welcome you all to the 416th session of our webinar. So I'm very happy to introduce our resource person today, and she is Ms. K.V. Shruti, who is currently a counseling psychologist at Kannur University, Kannur. So she is working as a counseling psychologist since 4 months at the Kannur University, and she has also been a skills trainer at National Institute of Language Acquisition. And she is an international certified career coach from ICCC Foundation, Career Guidance and Coaching. She has graduated her master's degree in counseling psychology from Rajiv Gandhi National Institute of Youth Development and bachelor's from Kannur University. So counseling psychology, research, leadership, psychological assessment, mental health counseling, and organizational psychology, and many more are her core skills. So we are very happy to have you here, Ms. Shruti, and thank you so much for accepting our request. So today, like every other country, we all admire Japan for their own style and tradition. So today we have Ms. Shruti to talk about Ikigai, the Japanese secret for long and happy life that everyone would want to know. So looking very much eagerly forward to listen to you. Without further ado, please take the session, and the audience is yours. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your warm welcome. Is the PPT is available now?
Yeah, it's starting to share. Let's see. Yeah, now we can see. It's in the last slide.
Yeah,
okay. Good.
Okay. Is it visible, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Hi, everyone, and good evening. So you can see the two terms. It's one is in Japan and another one is in English. So it's basically Ikigai. Most of them have familiar with it, but I am just giving some glimpses of it, like what is actually Ikigai and how it is started and how we can find our Ikigai, because I'm also a beginner in this this topic. So I will be just mentioning some of the things which I learned through the books and which I was very curious in learning that. So before starting, I would like to know that everybody wake up in the morning, right? So what is the reason for you to jump out of bed? Can someone say that? Or can anyone? What is the reason for you to jump out of your bed each morning? Any participants?
To start a new day with full enthusiasm and vigor.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Yeah, so basically, thank you, ma'am, for your words. So basically, Ikigai means the reason for jumping out of your bed. That is what Japanese people say. So here it is a meaning. Iki means life and gai means worth. So basically, Ikigai means life's worth. Simply, we can translate it as a life's worth. So that is the reason. That is the reason for you to jump out of bed and feel happy and feel purpose in your find purpose in your life. That is what Japanese people say. So before going to Ikigai, we have to know where it started, when it started. Then only we can find what is exactly Ikigai, right? So where did it started? So I guess everybody's familiar with karate, right? Because it's a martial art and it is very famous in India, and people are always learning it because as a self-defense mechanism, students and even women all are studying karate. This is karate is born from Japan, and in a very small town in Japan that is called Okinawa. It is an island where karate born. So there is, it is the same place where Ikigai also born. So Ikigai is born in an island which is known as Okinawa. So where basically the people's life is very simple, and what they seek is they won't be we cannot see people simply sitting and we always say that what you're doing, I'm simply sitting. They won't say that. So they are very active in their life, and they were fully happily living. So Okinawa is the center of attraction of Japan, and we can find the more people who live long in that. So that is where Ikigai born, and when it is, we cannot say, because it is the part of life, and very recently it is came out as a book. So that is why the word which is known as it is Ikigai, and that is a book which it is the term which is come out into the world by Hector Brescia and Francis Millers. They are the two people who lived in Japan and found and it is structured as like finding purpose in life, or how the living, it is a lifestyle. So basically these two people are who researched in it and shown to the world. So we cannot specifically say that it is started from this period of time, or from 19th century or 20th century it started. So it is in Japan, it is a lifestyle which is followed very long before. And now it is, what is exactly Ikigai? Okay, so we can together find out we can discover what is Ikigai. So let's begin then. So before going to that, you have to ask yourself four questions to yourself, and find out that whether is it there for you. Like the main four questions which you have to ask yourself will lead you to find your Ikigai. So first one is, what do I love? This is, we can be more interactive in this part, because I would like to know what do you love to do when you're free on a Sunday morning, or what would you do if money has no object in it, or what would you do on a Sunday morning if you had nothing else to do? So likewise, there are so many things which you love to do, right? So somebody can tell me what you love to do when you are, we cannot speak free, but when you are simply sitting, or what is your things which you drive you to do or makes you happy? Can someone say that?
Go on a walk along the line of nature.
Yeah, that's cool. Somebody else?
Shruti, are you able to see the chat? Because we do have some responses there.
No, I couldn't see that.
Are you using your computer?
Yeah, I'm using computer.
Okay, if you can click on the top, there will be a toolbar which has the chat option there.
Okay, fine. Okay, listening, just music, read books. Wow, good. So these are the things which we love to do, right? So because it will give you a happiness for the moment, and it will make you cool, calm, and be in that moment, right? So that is what Ikigai says. First, you have to find what you love. There may be hundred of things which you love to do, maybe dancing, singing, writing, going for a walk, or listening Ilaraja's music, or reading books, or some talking with friends, or gardening. So there are so many lists for one single person. So we cannot find it from one day. So what we have to do is, we have to find out what you love to do. You have to write it down, and it may be 100, 200, or 300. There will be so many lists, right? So first thing is, you have to write it down and what you love to do. So from that list, we will be coming down to our ikigai. So this is the first question which you have to ask yourself. Okay, so the second one is, what am I good at? There may be so many things which we love to do, right? Maybe, as I mentioned, maybe dancing, singing, reading books, or taking a bath, maybe, or eating. So that can all be if you love to do. But you may not be good at that, right? I'm a bathroom singer, okay? So we cannot say that I'm very good at that. So in this part, what you have to make the list from the loud part, like which you are good at that. Maybe you have the skills which you have acquired during your life. Like there are people who are not good at presentation, right? So during the course of your life or during your college time, by presenting so many things, you become good at that. So that can be your skill, right? Which you acquire during your life. So that is one thing, or which you can proudly say that I feel powerful for that, and I can control that I'm the center of attraction for that skill. So in this part, you can choose those kind of things which you are really good in that, and you can proudly say that I'm the center of attraction and I feel powerful when I do that. So can someone tell that something like that, which is part of your life? What you feel that you are really good in that, and you can be the host of that. Can someone share that?
Communication, listening skills.
Okay. Yes, of course. Communication is a really great skill. Psychology and statistics. Wow. Reading and remembering almost all of time. Wow, great. So as Bijit mentioned, communication is really a good part, which we can say that. So likewise, so the second which we have to focus is from the love, what you love to, we have to make it a what I'm good at list. So from that, we have to move to the third part, what the world needs. So from that list, if you're really good at you love to sing and you are really good at singing, then whether the world needs my singing, that is the next question which you have to ask. Whether the world needs, am I contributing by singing, am I contributing something to the society, or am I making someone happy, or is this really necessary for the society? So that is the next question which you ask yourself for finding your ikigai. So it comes like, what are the things affecting the world, your country, your state, your community, or what could you do make things better, or what are the ways that you can contribute to the society? So when you do this, the list becomes small, right? The first one is what you love. It becomes like 20, 300 things will be there. When you ask yourself that, what I am good at, it becomes little more shorter, like maybe like 10, 20 or 30, the list becomes reduced. And when it comes to the third question, what the world needs, it becomes really small, right? So can someone say that I'm really doing the things which is really world needs? Can anyone say that? You feel that I am doing the things which are really the world needs.
Ma'am, we are contributing a bit what we can in small ways, like mindful use of natural resources and contributing less waste and recycling, all that stuff.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. So likewise, some of the other way we are contributing, as Abhijit mentioned, communication. We are communicating with people and we are making them, even living in the moment and making others happy. That is also what the world needs, right? So we are humans and we are socially connected. So that is also what the world needs. So that is the third question which we have to ask, like finding your ikigai. Am I really contributing to the society, or am I really making things better in the world? So that is the third question which you can ask yourself, and which lead to the ikigai. And the final question is, what can I be paid for? We won't think about this, right? Because always we say that money cannot make you happy. But when we think in a certain point, we really need money, right, to live in the society. For food, we need money. Even nowadays, for water also, we need money. But when the people says that socially, we have to be responsible without thinking money, and we have to be selflessly working. But as a human, as a person, we really need money to live in the society. So when you have to think, the last but the very important part is whether these things which you have mentioned can paid, or is it paying for me? So it can be your potential career, or it can be the opportunities that you can be compensated for that might not be existed. For example, for the 10 or 20 years, YouTubers and bloggers are not there, right? But because if somebody is doing, we really don't know that can be paid, but it's become a career nowadays. So likewise, there are things which may not be existing, but gradually it can contribute to paid. So that is the last question which you have to ask yourself, and for finding your ikigai, whether it is paying for you. That service, for example, the service is needed for the society, and the society is giving back you as money. So can someone say that I am getting paid for what I love to do and what I'm good at and what the world needs? You have asked yourself the four questions, and in the end of it, you have to say that these four things are come into one thing.
Yeah. Can make people smile. Yes. I can make them happy. So I do open mics. Yeah. So sometimes I get paid for that.
Wow. Mine makes you paid. Cool. Okay. So so that is the way you find your ikigai. So this is a simple equation which you have to follow. Like the four questions which you can ask yourself, like what you love, the list be like 100 or 200 things. And from that, you have to ask yourself, like, what am I good at? Am I good at this one, or am I good at this one? Maybe you are not good in that one, but you can acquire, like, if you really wanted to be a good trainer, you have a communication skill, but you are not in that structured manner. What you have to do is you have to acquire that skill. So in that way, we have to acquire that skill by going to a trainer or attending classes or doing workshops. So we have to acquire that. That is also possible. So from that good list, you can think that whether it is the world need, really is the world is needing my list, from which the last question goes, what can I be paid for? Okay, so these are the four questions which you ask yourself and find make the list, and from that you will be getting three or four things which you really wanted to do, and you really loved it, and you are good at, and the world needs, and you will be paid for that. So that is what your ikigai, that is what Japanese people say, that is what your ikigai, and you can follow that in your life. Okay, so maybe you are familiar with the picture, because whenever you Google ikigai, you can see the picture. So so this is the ikigai diagram. Okay, so the ikigai diagram, you can see that there are two colors. Okay, so the dark part, which is already I gave you, like what you love, what the world needs, what you can be paid for, and what you're good at. So the lighter blue color is four words, which is very familiar to you, which is a very always we use, right? Mission, vocation, profession, passion, which we always use in our life. We can say that it's the four pillars of our life, like kind of thing. So in ikigai diagram, you can see that what you love and what the world needs become the mission. When you think of your mission, if you ask what is your mission in life, definitely you will be doing what you love to do, and also you will be contributing something to the world, right? So that becomes the mission of your life. And the second one is passion. You can see what you love and what you're good at becomes your passion. always people say, I'm passionate about drawing, because you love to do that and you're really good in that. That becomes your passion. And you can see that what you're good at and what you can pay becomes your profession. When you think of a profession, for example, teaching, or I'm a counselor, so counseling. So definitely I'm good in that. And also I'm paying for that. So that becomes my profession. So and when it comes to vocation, you are definitely paid and definitely the world needs it. So when we think of it, profession and vocation comes together. In our society, profession and vocation comes together. So that is, we cannot fully cut and say that this is the vocation and this is the profession. But the Japanese people say that what the world needs and what you can be paid for becomes vocation, and what you can be paid for and what you're good at become your profession. So these are the four terms which you have to focus. When you think of yourself, you can find out, maybe you are doing your passion and mission together, but you're not following your profession. So this is the way which we are doing it. Maybe you are happy and you're passionate about doing, but you're not getting paid for that. Maybe you're professionally qualified and you are a profession, choosing a profession, but you are not loving it. So likewise, four things comes in together, then only you can find your ikigai. That's what these people say. So you can see the smaller path inside, right? So the passion and mission, and there's a small space which is not filled. So when you follow your passion and mission together, that makes you delight and fullness, but no wealth. You're not getting paid for that, or you will get the fullness and delighted in your life because you're following your what you love and what you're good at and what the world needs. But what you can be paid is the money is lacking there. So that is definitely which we need. So that is what happens when you follow your passion and mission. So when you follow your mission and vocation, you can see the other part there, that is excitement and complacence, but sense of uncertainty. You will be so excited to do things, right? Because you're doing what you love to do and what the world needs, along with what you can be paid. But you may not be good at that, right? You will be doing something, but you are not really good at that. So, you feel uncertainty in some point of your life, right? Am I doing the right thing, or am I good at that? Ask yourself in some point of your life. So next one is, you can see vocation and profession, and there is a small part. So in that, when you follow your profession and vocation together, so you feel comfortable because you are the world needs that, and you are getting paid for that, well paid for that, and you are really good at that. But you may not be loving that, right? Good at that, but am I loving it? And in some certain point, you will be asking yourself, am I loving my career, or am I doing it really good? So you will be asking that question. So you'll be very comfortable doing that. But feeling of emptiness in a certain moment, you feel that, this is not what I really wanted, kind of thing. So that is what happens when you follow your passion and vocation together. So that is the last part, that is passion and profession. When you follow that, you will be satisfied, really satisfied, because you're following what you love to do, right? And you're doing that. And you're paid for that. But I'm contributing to the world. What I'm doing is not really needed for the world. You will be asking yourself that. So that is what happens when you follow your passion and profession together. So you will be satisfied, but feeling of uselessness, I'm not useless, kind of thing will happen. So usually what people follow is like either follow two or three, like passion, mission, vocation together, or passion, profession, vocation, or passion, mission, vocation. So likewise people do. But when these two comes together, you can find your ikigai. That is where you live your purpose of life, and that is where you can find your ikigai and follow your heart. It is what Japanese people say. So ask you a question, are you fully happy what you're doing, and did you find your ikigai? Can someone say that? With this explanation, can you say that I am following my ikigai, and I am in that process. Or can you say that I am in the passion mission, or passion vocation, or passion profession? So can anyone? Okay, fine. So many people are saying. I guess they're saying that they found the ikigai, right? Yes. Okay. So they are very early, and they already found the ikigai. So why we have to find our ikigai? So basically, if you find your ikigai, you can be successful in your life. That's what, because we have seen people, like we have seen students who are very confused after finishing their either BTech or degree, and still confused. Is this really I wanted to do in my life, or so confused in life, right? So when you can find your ikigai so early in your life, you can follow your heart and you can find your purpose in life. That's what the ikigai diagram and ikigai gives you. So it may not say that you have to find it so early. You can find it from during your studies. You can find it in between your job. Maybe you are doing a job and you will be still stuck in a moment where you feel that, okay, I'm not doing good. That moment you can also do it. And if you are retired, 55 or 60, and you're retired and still confused, there are people who are still confused, and they can also find the ikigai and that time. So there is no time limit or age limit where you can find your ikigai and follow yours. Because in Japan, people are finding it in the 90s, 100s, and even they are following it. So there is no age where you can find it and follow it. So that is the way, that is how we have to find your ikigai. So this is a simple technique, which maybe we always say in psychology, and all we say is that you have to follow your strength, and you have to find out your weakness and build your strength. Likewise, this is a simple technique which you have, but we cannot do it in one day, because you have to introspect yourself and find out what you really wanted. So it may take months, it may take years to find yours, but when you find it, you can live your life happily and fully. Because this is a proven technique or proven lifestyle which is followed by Japanese people. Okay, so this is something really interesting. Actually, it was put forth by Ken Mogi. He's a neuroscientist. He also discovered something in Ikigai, and he wrote a book called Awakening of Ikigai. So in that, he says that there's a 5 pillars that enhance your ikigai. Basically, we have to start with small things. First one is start with small thing, the 5 pillars. The first one, start small. Because if you have found so many things, I am good at so many things and I love so many things, you will start, okay, so good, I have so many things. What will I do? So start with small, because you cannot think multiply, and you cannot do multiple tasks, right? So start small, that's what he says. Then accept yourself, that is the second one which you have to do, because acceptance is what really wanted. Then only we can find our ikigai, because if you do not accept your weakness, then you will be following the wrong thing, right? So you have to accept yourself and find yourself. That is the second pillar, which he says. Then connect with the world around you. Because during this corona time, we have come into a circle where we only see ourselves, right? Just now, I'm only seeing myself. That is a weird part. When you are talking to someone, you're seeing yourself in a computer. And I can understand that there are people around other side, but I'm not communicating, right? So that's a really weird thing. So connecting with the world around you is the next thing which you can do to find your ikigai and to enhance yourself. So connecting doesn't mean like everyday connection or seeing people, but even in nowadays we have phone and we have different different medium to communicate. But we just give thumbs up, we just give hi, good morning messages, but we don't really talk, right? So connecting with the world around you can make you, or you can find and you can enhance your ikigai. Next one, seeking out small joys. Happiness in small things. When you usually we say success means when you get a rank or when you get a birthday present, you will be so happy, right? But we have to find happiness in small things. When somebody smiles at you, say hi, you have to feel happy, and you have to find happiness in that sense. Or somebody says you, your dress is good, or somebody says you, you look smart today. So that's the way you can give happiness to some other thing, some other people, and feel find joy in small things. That is what he says. Then, and the final one is being in and the here and now. Always we are running. Either we will be in the past or we will be in the future. Always we think that, okay, I'm done this. Okay, I talked to my friend in a very, really bad manner. So what should I do? Okay, it's already done. So what? So always we think the past, right? Or we will be thinking about the future. Okay, what will I be doing tomorrow? What is, how will be my career? And what will happen? I'm 25. And so we will be always worrying about the future, or we will be always worrying about the past. So we won't enjoy the present. So what he says that being in the here and now can make you more happy and enhanced. And it's very easy. So these are the five pillars by Ken Mogi. First one is starting small and accepting your. Second one is accepting yourself. And third one is connecting with the world around you. And fourth one is seeking out small joys. And final one is being in here and now. We always use this, but we say to people, start with small, but we don't know that this can lead to finding your ikigai and enhance that. So these are the five things which Ken Mogi says which can enhance your ikigai. Okay. So have you heard kata and ikigai? Anyone? Because I always say ikigai and find your ikigai and follow at the fullest. But we can start with kata and ikigai also. So this is, it sounds weird, okay, because we can't live a full 24 hours with our happy and with our passion or vocation or mission kind of thing, right? So starting with kata and ikigai makes you find your full, right? So what, for example, I am a person who works from 10 to 5. So you have a time where you will be working with 10 to 5 time slot, where you have certain kind of jobs and you have to be doing that. So there are times before 10 a.m. and after 5 p.m., right? So we can do, you can pick a time slot like before 10 a.m. or after 5 p.m. and you can start doing your ikigai. For example, if you are found that these are dancing, singing, and drawing are my ikigai, then, but it may not give you money. So what you can do is you can do, find a time slot where you, or after 5, where you doing your ikigai makes you happy and makes you live, right? So that is the way we can start slowly, because if you are doing some job right now and you cannot skip, right? Or you cannot simply stop it and shift it to another thing and find, I found my ikigai. So this is my ikigai, so I have to shift it. So because of so many reasons, we cannot do that, right? So what we can do is, you can start with a part-time where you find a time slot, like 1 hour or 2 hours, where you do what you really wanted to do, what you really love to do, what you're really good at. So slowly it gives you you will give you money and you can really contribute to the world. That's the way you have to do. So this is something which you can try and which you can practice. Start with a part-time ikigai. Okay, I found my ikigai, but I couldn't find after this. Like, I found done what do I love. Then I found what I'm good at, and I done what the world needs, and I what it is paid. I also started doing my part-time ikigai also, but still I am lost. What will I do, right? there are times, right? Still I'm confused and still I'm lost and I couldn't find my ikigai. What we can do? Sira, there is a picture which shows chocolates. Okay. So everybody, I guess everybody is familiar with the chocolates. I'm very fond of chocolate. That's why I took the picture. Okay. So you can see that when you go to a supermarket, the first thing which you see is chocolates, right? Can someone say that how do you pick a chocolate from this? Can anyone say that how do you pick a chocolate from this?
Taste it once.
Yeah, you have to pick one.
We pick the familiar ones.
Yeah, okay, you pick the familiar one. Okay, somebody was telling some other things.
Maybe based on the previous experience of tasting it.
Okay.
Any other choice? Like, you want to pick something that you have not tried before?
Okay. So anyone else? Okay. So thank you, ma'am. And that's the way we do, right? So first, maybe I would be checking my purse first. Okay. So because if I'm having enough money, I can go for it, right? So first thing I do is, like, I will check my purse if I'm having the money for it. Then second one is, as ma'am was telling, like, I will try the familiar one because I know the taste of it. Or I will go for the new one because I haven't known the taste. So maybe I will pick that. So likewise, we prioritize things, right? So when we go for a shopping or when we choose the things, we will be prioritizing or we will be trying different aspects. As here, maybe I will be checking my money or I will be checking the new thing or I will be picking something healthy. Maybe if I'm in a diet, I will be taking something sugarless. So likewise, we will categorize things and then only we will go take a chocolate from there. Likewise, you can also try ikigai to find out that, because one day we cannot find our ikigai and tell that this is what I am going to do from tomorrow and from that I will be getting money or I will be giving to the society what the society really needed. So we cannot find it in a single day. So we have to start from small things and we have to do it like, okay, prioritizing things and trying it. Like if you try new chocolate, it may be good for you. Then you won't go for that, right? Next time you won't go for that chocolate. So likewise, we have to jump. Sometimes you have to jump into things and try. So likewise, ikigai also is something which we have to try and find out. One day you cannot find, like, okay, this is my day and this is what my ikigai. So you have to keep on trying things and find out that what is really apt for me. So finding a chocolate is this much difficult. So you have to think that this is what I am. This is finding your purpose in life. So it really takes time and really need patience to find that. So within this 1 hour, I cannot tell you. If you ask me, did you find your ikigai? I cannot tell you. I found my ikigai. I'm in the process. So likewise, everybody has to try things and find out whether it is apt for me. So that is what I have to tell. And okay, so this is a technique which I usually use, like take classes. For example, if I am not good in application, for example, using presentation, PPT, if I wanted to be really good in that, I take classes for that. That's okay, right? We have to take classes. If I am not good in that, then practice it. Definitely, we have to practice it. So then say yes. It is very difficult for people to be assertive, right? We won't say yes and no to the people. So start saying yes when you find your ikigai. When you are in the process of finding your ikigai, start saying yes. If you want to try that thing, you have to say yes and try it. So these are some of the things which you can do. Like if you want to acquire a skill, you have to practice it. You have to go for the classes. You have to take it and you have to try it. So these are some methods which I follow. It may not work for you. Maybe you have to find your own way to make your skills sharpen. So finding after this class, if you are trying for this, like, okay, I will find my ikigai. So you started writing, like, this is what I love, and this is what I'm good at, and this is what the world needs, and this is what they pay for me. And finally, you get something, but that is not what you really, that is not matching for your thing. So don't look behind it, okay, I done this, and it is wrong. Don't think in that way. But if it is like a skill which you can acquire, like interpersonal skill, you can acquire presentation skill. So this is what came in between finding ikigai. So you have to learn it. You have to go for training classes and you have to find it. So these are some of the methods which I personally follow. Okay. And this is something really interesting. Okay. How long do you want to live in the world? Can I ask you? Have you thought of this question? How long do you want to live in the world?
If it's going to be a healthy time, it would be endless, I would say.
Okay, endless. Okay, can someone say any numbers? Like, I want to live up to 100, or I want to, okay, 100, 60, fine.
90.
So, okay, 95, book, 85, okay. So basically, in India, the average life expectancy, lifespan is 72, right? Yeah, I guess 72, right? So this is too far beyond that, 8500. So you have to really try hard for reaching that, everybody. Okay, so that's why I also think that, okay, I wanted to live up to 100. We don't see ourselves dying so early, right? So why I asked you, like, I already mentioned, right, Ikigai came from an island, which is Okinawa. It is in Japan, where the people who are living are more and centenarians, because they are the people who came in Guinness Book, okay? Checking Guinness Book, more people are from Japan who are reached more than 100, like those who are living... people who are more is from Okinawa. So there are 13 lessons from Japanese centenarians, which is given in this book, Ikigai. So I would like to share with you for giving a glimpse of, because so many people told me, like, I would like to read. So you can read and find out what the people are saying. So the authors have conducted an interview with the people who are living there, with the centenarians. So they basically said five things which is very relevant and which they follow to reach that level, up to 100 or 90. And they're not having any chronic illness or they're not having any problem in their life. So they're living a very healthy and happy life. That is the major thing which we have to focus, because whenever I had grandmother, okay? So whenever I see her, she will be like, okay, I am aged, or I cannot do anything, kind of. Always that sounds comes from her mouth. So, but when I read this book, they were like more energetic than I am. And they have given some lessons, which is really worth. So these are the five lessons. So I will be reading what they are, they told in this book while they're conducting the interview. So the first one is, don't worry. Some of the person was telling, like, the secret to a long life is not to worry and to keep your heart young. Don't let it grow old. Open your heart to people with a nice smile on your face. If you smile and open your heart, your grandchildren and everyone else will want to see you. So this is what said. Don't worry, everybody. That's what we do, right? We always worry about things. Even I worry now. Like, when before the sessions, I was like, okay, what is going to happen? I am really worried. So don't worry about things. Things will be happy. Take it as a smile. Give a smile on your face. That's what this person says. And next one is, cultivate good habits. So one of the centenarians said it like, I plant my own vegetables and cook them myself. That is my ikigai. So basically, ikigai doesn't mean that you have to become a teacher. That is my ikigai. Teaching is my ikigai. Or counseling, for example, counseling is my ikigai. So that is a profession. So what this lady was telling, planting vegetables and cooking myself is my ikigai. So the simplest thing can be your ikigai. So cultivate good habits. It can be exercise, or painting, or draw, or singing, or walking, going for a walk. So cultivating good habits makes you live long. And next one is nurture your friendship every day. So there is one person who says it like, I say hello and see you later to the children on the way to school, and wave at everyone who goes by me in the car. Drive safely, I say. Between 7:20 a.m. and 8:15 a.m., I am outside on my feet the whole time, saying hello to people. Once everyone's gone, I go back inside. This is what he does. Okay, he always says hi to people and say, see you later. And somebody's driving car, he says, drive safely. So that's what makes him happy. And he always nurtures that friendship. So that simple words makes him happy and live longer. So this is one of the person, the centenary. He says that nurture your friendship every day. So just think to yourself that whether am I nurturing my friendship? Am I contacting my school friend? Am I keeping my friendship alive? Am I really talking to them in a healthy manner? So think to yourself, and if you're not doing it, start doing it, because it makes you to reach up to 100 years. That's what this book says. Okay. Then next one is live an unhurried life, because we are always hurry to do something, or hurry to research. So people say that live in a hurry, unhurried life. So one of the person said it like, my secret to a long life is always saying to myself, slow down and relax. You live much longer if you're not in a hurry. So have you ever told yourself that, please slow down. Slow down and relax. Take a deep breath. You're okay. Have you done that before? So you have to do that. That's what he says. He says that the secret of a long life, to live up to 100, you have to relax and be in that moment and take a deep breath. So that's how. That's the way you can find your purpose in life and live up to 100. And the final one is be optimistic. We always say that be optimistic and start to live a life. When you wake up in the morning, think very positively and take it very positively. So be optimistic. And one of the persons says that every day I say to myself, today will be full of health and energy. Live it to the fullest. So that is the way he starts the day. So I asked you, what is the reason for jumping out of your bed? So when you become the optimistic and start with a smile, the day will be very happy. That's what he says. So these are the five things which he's the interviews. There may be more because these are some of the things which is mentioned in the book. And which always we say that don't worry, and you have to cultivate your good habit and always connect with people. Don't be hurry and be optimistic. But are we actually doing? So we have to check ourselves. Are we actually doing? Am I running for the future? Or am I always worried about my past? So we have to think ourselves and tell yourself that, okay, these are the things which I am missing. So these are the 5 points which is mentioned in this book, which is made those people to reach up to 100 and live a happy life. Okay, so retirement. This is also very familiar for us. So what is your concept of retirement? Can I get your point? Anyone? What is your concept of retirement? Are you familiar with the term retirement? Yes, ma'am? What? No, I'm asking you, what is your concept of retirement?
Stop running.
Okay, stop running. Fine. That's cool answer. Anyone else? Taking rest, okay. That's true. Okay, so these are the comments which I get from, yeah? There was someone who was telling something. Okay. So retirement, basically, what we say is preparation for all things, okay? That's cool. So these are the things which we have in our mind, right? Retirement means taking a pause into your life, you're running life and taking a rest and preparing for old life, or doing nothing. That can also be right. Before retirement, you will be working from a time slot and coming back to home and again going back. So after retirement, you will be having nothing to do, right? So, but in Japan, they don't retire. That is good. They won't. Okay, there is somebody saying that retirement only from my institution and not from my profession. That's cool. That's the more they do, right? They are taking retirement as a new journey. Okay. I don't know whether you know this person because he is not as famous. Okay. So he is an athlete. He's from Japan, and he's died from his too. He's the first person to get Olympic medals from Japan. Okay, so he's the first person to get Olympic medal in athletes. So when basically for athlete people, we know that they have to retire so early, and we have seen Sachin was not taking retirement. People have started telling like, okay, he has to take retirement. He's already in 38 or 35. He has to take retirement. His health is going. He's not fit for the sport, right? So likewise, for the athlete people, they have to retire so early from the field. So when he wanted to retire from his life, so he was asking himself like, what is it that I wanted to achieve by playing sports? That is a question which he asked himself. And what the answer was, he's like, for me, what I wanted to achieve through competing in the track and field was to change people's perception. That is why he was playing the sports. So what he started after his retirement was started a sports academy and making the people's perception and changing the people's perception towards the sports. So in his 36 or 37 years, he found his ikigai and started doing that. He couldn't find before that. When he was going for the athlete and when participating in athlete, he didn't know that his life, or that is what he really wanted to do. After he retired, he found his ikigai, and that is what changed his life. And he is making other people's perception about sports and training people. So retirement is a time where we always think that, okay, this is the time for me to relax, and started to think about my old days. But in Japan, people won't simply sit and think about retirement. They don't have a term retirement. They always will be busy doing something. And in this book, they have mentioned it like, okay, they start from their life very early, like their morning, they start from 6 a.m. and they go to bed early. Up to that that period, we cannot see anyone simply sitting and simply thinking. They will be always busy doing something. They skip from one thing to another and always keep busy in their life. Maybe talking with people, or going for a walk, or doing gardening, or selling things. Even in his even in 90s or 100, in their 100, they will be selling and making money. So this is the life which Japan people are following. So retirement is not a stop or not a full stop your life. This is just a beginning, because I already mentioned that when you find your ikigai, there is no time. If you are in your 55, you can find your ikigai. If you are in your 60, you can find your ikigai and follow that. So retirement only, it is just a transition from your work life to another life. So if maybe in your career, you have somewhere lost your passion, right? Maybe you are good in dance, or you couldn't do it when you are doing a profession, or lost your dancing somewhere. So after your retirement, you can pick it and you can go for it. So there is no time, or there is no particular time where you can start your ikigai or start following that. Okay, so with this note, I would like to conclude the session, because finding ikigai, I can only express you how to find your ikigai. I'm just giving you a glimpse of ikigai, and introducing this book. It is really amazing book. So Japan people follow their life in a very different manner, and they follow a very different diet, and they follow a very different exercises. It is also mentioned in it. So this is only just a beginning. Within 1 hour, I cannot tell anything. So I am also finding my ikigai. I am also in the journey. So with this Dalai Lama's card, I would like to conclude my session. And thank you so much for your patient listening, and you were a wonderful participant. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Shruti. It was a happy and a cheerful presentation, I would say, because I could live up with whatever you have said, you know, like I can feel what you're talking, and I like so much about that. So this is time for question and answers, and the participants, you are requested to unmute your mics if you have any questions for the resource person, and you're very much welcome to give your feedback or put your questions or comments in the chat box. Thank you. We have got some nice feedback.
Yeah, lovely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the bunch of you. Come on.
So, Ms. Shruti, I have one question. So, yes, it was very clear about what is Ikigai and the search for it. It was very interesting to know. So, my question is, can there be more than one Ikigai in one's life?
Yes, question. Definitely, ma'am.
Yeah, and second question is, can it keep changing throughout?
Yes, ma'am. Because when you find your ikigai, it doesn't mean that is what you really want, because when in our career also we switch from one career to another, right? So ikigai is just a simple term which where you have to find it and follow it, which makes you happy for a certain period of time. Maybe in sometimes after that you can switch to another. That is not a problem. They are not mentioned. They are saying that they are following multiple ikigais, and like they may be walking is my ikigai. Somebody says that. Gardening is my ikigai. There are people who say, but what I mentioned in the first was this is what which is formulated by these people. Like they found it like what I love, and which will help you to find your career and be in that profession. It can be really helpful for the people who will be we do achievement tests and aptitude tests and all, right? So likewise, when you find your ikigai through this, when you follow that, you can be successful in your career. So if you are in a retirement stage, and that is not a problem, you can switch from one ikigai to another. So this is simple equation where you can find. When we give it to the students, it will be really helpful for them to follow that and be successful in career. So this is a small technique which they have mentioned it, but I don't think Japan people really you follow this kind of structured version. It is throughout their life they are following some kind of ikigai. So this is what these authors formulated it in this way and made it for other people to follow it. So ikigai can be different.
Yeah, thank you very much. And I love the five statements, you know, what you told about the pillars to enhance ikigai. I think it is really eye-catching and good to remember also. Thank you for that. And we have got a couple of questions in the chat box. Is there any Indian model equivalent to Ikigai? It is by Dr. Suresh Kumar.
Yeah, I got it. Actually, this concept is, maybe I forgot to mention it. It is really similar to the logotherapy, which is followed in our psychology, Viktor Frankl's logotherapy. So basically, nowadays they are not really following that. But logotherapy also mentioned it somewhat. The logotherapy also following meaningful life, right? So I cannot surely say that ikigai. But when you see yoga and Buddhism concept, it is somewhat similar to ikigai. In we say yoga as a exercise, right? But yoga is a lifestyle. Really, it is a lifestyle. So it is same from our Indian culture, but we really don't know that it is a lifestyle. So we always follow it as an exercise. So I think ikigai can be related to yoga and the Buddhism concept also, Zen and all those things. So I guess that is related to ikigai.
Thank you. And there is one statement with a question. Great people like Mother Teresa have found ikigai without payment part. Is this statement right?
This is actually, you can, because it is really hard to tell. Gandhiji found his ikigai and he didn't pay, get paid. And the same way, it is a really tricky question actually. So, but as I mentioned, what ma'am was asking me, can you switch your ikigai from another auto? It is a simple technique which you can follow and find your ikigai. When you find that, you will be accessing life. It doesn't mean that you will be paid or things. So that's a very tricky question. I'm a little confused about that part also. But what these people are saying that this is a formula which is done or formulated by these people, like the Hector Gracie and Francis Miral is the people who have taken it from the Japan and shown to the world, right? So they have formulated this. So when we see the inside part of the book, we can say that there are people who are not follow like the paid part. It is really absent in them. So I guess it is not really needed. But when you are telling to people when you have to find your ikigai, when you have to follow your passion, really money is needed, right? So that is another part. But when it comes to Mother Teresa, it is a selfless love, right? She was doing that. So that is a different.
I go with you, Mishruti, because in my opinion, what I feel is for most people, passion and profession are different, okay? So yes, it is very hard to answer this part. And it depends on your, commitments, responsibilities. It's a bit a complex phenomenon to, open it. So thank you anyway for your nice answer. And there's one question from Anita ma'am. She's asking, when you talked about logotherapy or ikigai, is it something very similar to Maslow's stage of self-actualization, the highest stage?
Yes. Actually, we can relate. When we go in depth into psychology, we can see so many theories are really connecting with this. Self-actualization is one thing, and logotherapy is really, it is also mentioned in this book. Logotherapy is really mentioned in this book also. So it is really similar to this. So when we find this, we can relate that self-actualization and logotherapy to
I don't hear Mishruti. Is she talking? Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yes, somebody, is that the answer was fine?
Okay. Yeah, the answer was fine, and we have got an input from Abhijit sir that he says, great people, their ikigai will make financial support boring. Money is vital, somehow it fits. Yeah. Agreed by me. I don't know about the group.
Okay.
If you have any views or opinions on that, you can just share. And okay. Anita ma'am says that she couldn't hear your response, Mishruti. Can you go with one more time on Maslow's self-actualization?
Okay, am I audible, ma'am?
Yeah, now you're audible.
Okay.
And so,
about hello.
She's fine. You can proceed, please.
Okay. So it is somewhat similar to self-actualization, but when it comes to self-actualization, it is the highest, like regarding Mahatma Gandhi or Mother Teresa or kind of people, which we always say is in self-actualized people, right? So the same question, like paid parties really lacking there, but we can relate the logotherapy, self-actualization, all can be guide. So we can, in some aspect, we can say that Maslow's self-actualization is somewhat related to Ikigai.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Mashruti, for your kind answering to our doubts and clarifying things. So I think now it's time for us to thank you. And now I request our core team member, Dr. Salim, to give his words of thanks on behalf of all of us. Thank you from myself.
Thank you, Dr. Chandra. It's my pleasure to give the vote of thanks today for the topic of Ikigai, the Japanese secret by Shruti ma'am. Ma'am, it was a very nice, wonderful presentation by you. And really everybody want to do what they love, actually. The career they want to choose what they love. At the same time, it should be world's needs also. That is the thing they are missing, the balance. At the same time, they have to be paid also. And it should be good for everyone. So these four combination, really everybody is missing actually. So probably they can have the combination of, each we are giving the 25%, somebody will be 25, somebody some per 10, some 5, something like that. So definitely we gave the 5 pillars, like starting the small, accepting ourselves and connecting with the world. So all those points definitely will give us to maintain our Ikigai. And there's a good lesson of Japanese centenarians, like don't worry and cultivate our habits, all those things. So it was a nice, wonderful session. So I feel that all the participants and all the core team and all the members definitely learn a lot from you. And I think it's a big topic. I think you saw the book of Ikigai. So it means several sessions, I think so. So anyway, if time permits, you can take another some of the session on some. So we learned a lot today. Thank you so much. And I would like to thank you on behalf of American College Madurai, MS Chellamurthy Institute Madurai, and Red Pond Education Psychological Research Center Madurai, and Madras School of Social Work Chennai, and Psycho-Oncological Association Turkey. Thank you, Shruti ma'am, and thank you, participant. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you.
So the takeaway could be like, we are going to live our Ikigai, Mishruti. Thank you for, enlightening with us. Thank you, one and all. See you tomorrow in yet another session. Same time, same link. Until then, bye-bye.